I got a red hat, but I don't know where it's at. Oh, bars.
What?
Alexa, what's the weather today?
The current weather is 9 degrees Fahrenheit with partly sunny skies. Today's forecast has cold temperatures, with a high of 23 degrees and a low of 5 degrees.
Okay. Me not sure about the snowplow guy, because he seemed to be doing stuff a little redundant. Why is it a pile right there? And why did he plow everything to where it's blocking the people's units? Oh my God. I'm gonna get this mail. Ain't no way in hell I'm walking out there. Look at this, I had to. See, this is what people gonna be expecting me to do if they come to their unit.
Here's a bird's eye view of some stuff. Anybody wanna build a snowman? What I wanna say to the snow is, do you wanna catch these hands? The gate's fixed. The motor had popped off. At least it's sunny. But don't let the sunny fool you. Look at all the snow. You can build an igloo.
And now I'm stuck again. What the hell? Why? See, this is some BS. That man just came out here. They weren't able to come out yesterday. And the lady told me on the phone, she's like, we're backed up till next weekish. And I'm like, what? She was like, yeah, everybody's calling about the same thing. And I get that. But then they figured us into their schedule for today and came out. And he was like, you're good to go. He tussled around with the gate for a while. And now it's doing the same thing. And I don't think it's anything on the photo eye. This is annoying. This is absolutely annoying. In real life, annoying. I don't know what the hell and why. Ain't nothing on the photo eye. The man dug the gate out better than me. Got it. I clicked the turn it off, turn it back on from the box, and it closed back. So I don't know. We'll see. This gate annoying. They all are. And in the winter though, it's not really much you can do about it. It's all ignorant.
the next day.
Looking good. The current weather is 13 degrees Fahrenheit with cloudy skies. Today, you can look for an abundance of clouds and snow flurries. With a high of 22 degrees and a low of 13 degrees.
No more snow. Hey, what's up, baby? Hey, Pookie. Hey, honey. Hey, honey. Alright. Oh, I got a short day today. When I come back, I'm off for 2 days. Y'all gotta look at this, though. Not the cat, because he mean mugging me right now. That's his little new box. Look how much snow is on my back porch. You see that, right? That's quite a bit. Here's a better view without the screen. That's a lot. Like, I could go lay down in that. It's like a mattress, a snow mattress. And look at that snow over there beyond the balcony in that pile. It's a lot of snow, baby. A lot. So, I got several units that might be rented today. So, because good old... Oh, my God. I'm going to have to ride down here. This is ridiculous. If somebody needs to come use their unit, they're going to have to shovel the over... This is a problem, but I'm going to show y'all. I'm going to drive down there because I got to go to one of the units down there and shovel in front of the door so the people won't be like, I can't get in it. How you going to present something to somebody and they can't even get in the unit? Or like, I tell you, let me take you out to look at it and we get to it and I got to shovel first. So prepare yourself ahead of time. If you know people going to rent unit 203, go check 203 way before they even come. You know what I'm saying? Shovel, sweep, whatever you got to do. So when you take them to that unit, you don't get one of these looks. Which used to happen a lot back at the stowage. Because relying on other people to do stuff sometimes don't work. But anyway, I got about 3 units to unshovel. And yeah, somebody coming in the gate right now. They probably pissed. Because they going to go to their unit. And they can't even get the hell in it. Who is this coming through? Let's see. Oh, they coming down here. Look at this. I would be pissed if I came here to go in my unit. And it gets worse as it gets closer. Look at this. This don't make no sense to me. Like, he don't know how to plow. You're supposed to, when you, look, let me give y'all a plowing lesson right quick. When you have a storage facility that's outside and you don't know how to plow, you're going to have a problem with everybody. So, what you have to do, when you coming down that road, before you do anything, look at it, look at this. Look at this. If any of these people, they're going to be pissed. Do you know how many? We have 600 and some units here. I'm not about to go shovel in front of every unit. They need to have that man come back out here and do that. So anyway, when you're plowing, you're supposed to go down this row as close to the units without hitting them and push it toward the middle. Okay? You see what I'm saying? You go down this row, push it toward the middle. You go down here, push it toward the middle. Then you come back and you grab the stuff in the middle and push it to where you're going to put the snow. You don't go down the middle, throw the snow up on the people's doors, and that's it. Like, that's stupid. People don't know how to do stuff, and it irritates me. And, I mean, what did they do last year? Okay, somebody stopped me already and was like, we can't get in our unit either. So I had to shovel it. I don't understand this. This is like really pissing me off. Like, when I worked at Simply Self Storage, we had a company that came out and they did it right. And I never had this problem in the wintertime. Look at this. big boulders. People, I'm telling you, you go on a storage facility and it's an outside and it's a weather climate change where you get snow. You don't get a snowplow person that doesn't know how to plow, okay? And knowing how to plow is moving that stuff away from the doors to the middle and then pushing it. If I knew how to use that machine, I would do it myself. But I'd tear this place up. I totally forgot about the climate control building, so I gotta do the doorways. There are six. Wait, two on the side, one on each side, two on the front. And, yep. So I gotta shovel six walkways right quick because he did the same thing over here. So some folks came in here. Let me see if I can cover their name up. That's not the point. They came in here and they brought this Prove It. Prove It ketones. Ketones in 60 minutes. Anyway, the lady came in here. Baby, she said I used to weigh 500 pounds. And I was like, I'm looking at her like, for real? So she was telling me about the ketones and the Prove It. And, you know, it's an MLM. You know what I'm saying? It's a multi-level marketing situation. I ain't selling it, though. I don't give a crap. I don't care if I drink this and it changes my life. I'm not trying to sell nothing. That is not my way of life. You know, I could be gung-ho about selling stuff at one moment, and the next moment, you don't even hear nothing from me, which is inconsistent, which is not a good seller. So, with that being said, they gave me something to sample. Gave me something to sample. It is called Root Bear Float. Root Bear Float. Ketones up. Keto up. Instead of 7-Up, keto up. This is by Prove It. Level up your lifestyle with clean fuel. Let's see. Best enjoy cold with or without food. They got sugar alcohol in here, vitamin C, B6, B12, calcium, 90, magnesium. It's a lot of sodium in here. Potassium. Let's see. Natural flavors, potassium, pomegranate extract. Okay. And this is, she said it was, it's supposed to taste like a root beer float. I think I'm gonna pour it in my cup. I don't like drinking out of cans. Unknown cans, you know? I guess I shouldn't pour it all in there. Okay. It smells like root beer or root bear. Ooh, choke my life out. It's strong. It's pretty good. Oh, wow. Caffeine equivalent to 8 to 12 ounce cup of coffee. They also have some decaffeinated stuff as well. She's actually going to bring me back a sample pack so I can try some other stuff. I guess it's some package that you can mix with your water. But that baby says she lost 100 and some pounds. I think what she said was close to 200. So this is supposed to give you energy, curb your appetite. Although I don't really have like a super big appetite, my problem is eating late. I gotta stop that, but this is not about no weight loss journey. So go ahead on. I don't wanna hear it. Keep them comments to yourself. I'm just trying this stuff because it was free. good. So I'm gonna say the ketones drink, I don't know if it gave me energy. I'm usually an energetic person. I think personally that me running back and forth outside to shovel snow that should not have to have been shoveled. Anyway, let me stop. Going in and out was giving me energy, and then I sold several units today, and I don't know. I mean, I only drank it one time, so I'm usually an energetic person and upbeat, bubbly, or whatever, so I don't know. But it did taste good. It really did taste like a root beer float. It did not have an aftertaste, which is very important for me. Like drinks that are supposed to help you with weight loss or whatever the crap, or just even enjoyable drinks, if there's a bad aftertaste, I'm not going to do it, okay? So I don't know. They're supposed to be bringing me some samples next week, so I will try the samples. If I like it, I'll think about it, but I definitely don't want anybody trying to harass me to join their multi-level marketing situation. I don't do the pyramid schemes. I'm not a salesperson in that regard, so yeah.
Okay. I know how to go.
See, that's the type of stuff I be talking about. To be able to see beauty like that. And this is a perfect area to do it because it's, well, right now it's not a lot of trees blooming because they're dead because it's wintertime. But to be able to look out my window from my desk and see this beautiful sunset is, it just amazes me. I know that might sound cheesy, but that's me. Happy Black History Month. So I got two for the 4th and the 5th of February because I didn't upload a video yesterday, but I ain't forget. So we'll start with February 4th. On this day in 1986, the U.S. Postal Service issued a commemorative postage stamp honoring the one and only Sojourner Truth. She was born Isabella Baumfree. That's Baumfree. I didn't know that. Truth changed her name in 1843 and went on to become a famed African-American abolitionist and women's rights activist, known for her powerful speeches. And her most famous one, which addressed gender inequalities, was entitled, Ain't I a Woman? In the description, I put the URL so that you can go read it for yourself. I think you should. And so we'll get on to February 5th. And this one is very near and dear to my heart because this man is an absolute genius when it comes to music. When I was a kid, I don't remember how old I was at the time. Again, very near and dear to my heart. When I tell you, let me see, I don't know how old I was, but I was in the basement. I was fumbling through my parents' albums and I came across this. Right. The cover of the album got my attention. So I took it out, put it on the record player. And the very first track that was on that album was called Watermelon Man. When I tell you that song, that track, that production of music was, it just floored me as a child. And it was by Herbie Hancock. So Herbie Hancock was born on April 12th, 1940 in Chicago, Illinois, into a musical family. His father was a government meat inspector and his mother was a secretary. Herbie began studying the piano at the age of 7. He started his education with classical music. on February the 5th, 1952, along with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, he played the first movement of Mozart's Piano Concerto No. 26 in D major, K537. It says Coronation. I'm not a music buff as far as like knowing stuff like that, but I'm still impressed with the man, okay? He was only 11 years old at the time. That's got to be amazing. But I'm telling you, if you've never listened to Watermelon Man, I need you to go listen to it. I have linked in the description a YouTube link so that you can go check out Watermelon Man. And I need you to listen to it. Put headphones on if you can. And really listen to how the music builds. That impressed me so much as a child. But anyway, what's your Black history?
You made it. But make sure you thumb this up, comment, subscribe, and share.